Hi, I'm Heidi with Washtenaw County Weatherization. I am going to be performing an energy audit at this home today. So I'm going to be looking at the outside of the home first to see what we're looking at, look at the structure, see how the roof is, look for any areas that may need attention on the outside that would be within the weatherization program. This is a very old home that we're looking at right now. There's a lot of opportunities that I already know that I'm going to be looking for. We'll start on the outside, I'll do some drawings and do some measurements and then head on in. Typically when we come into the home, we're going to start either in the basement or in the attic area upstairs. But right now, we'll be looking at the basement, looking at this, you know, 1890s style home. I'm going to be looking at the furnace, looking at the ducting and seeing if there's any leaks where cold air is being pulled in and pushed up through the home, because that's one of our big things, is really pushing the efficiency of your home and doing a whole home energy analysis. And the other thing we're going to be looking at is going to be the water heater. We're going to do a backdrafting test to make sure the water heater drafts properly. And then we're also going to be checking for gas leaks, carbon monoxide issues. We'll also be looking at the floor joists, the foundation walls, and any other things that may be causing like health and safety issues in the home.
All right, so we're in the attic. I can see that there's newer fiberglass insulation that someone put on top of some old cellulose. I do see that there's, you know, open wall cavities from the inside where it's warm and treated up into the untreated attic area. So that's a great opportunity for moist air and heat to rise and come up into the attic, causing ice damming and other issues. So there's a lot of opportunities here to increase the energy efficiency of the attic.
Now we're on the first floor. We're going to be looking at the doors and windows, measuring them for their square footage, because if there's no wall insulation, we want to take the doors and windows out of that square footage calculation. We'll look for the thermostat to see if it's blocked by anything. If it's behind, you know, a shelf, a TV, it's not necessarily getting the proper airflow, so it might not be reading the temperature in the house the way it should be. We're in a bedroom looking at the smoke detector, so that is good that there is one here. We're also looking at, you know, there's a couple windows in this bedroom. This window right here would cost about $2,500 to replace. So when people are asking, you know, hey, can't you do my doors and windows? You know, I feel so cold near them. Well, in reality, you know, that $2,500 could go a much further distance when we do air sealing in the attic or in the basement crawl space areas. Let's say you've got 10 to 14 windows. You add those numbers up. That's a lot of money to where we're not gonna get the savings. We're in the bathroom now. I do see that there is a bath fan, so we are going to test that to find out what the air movement is on that fan. We want to make sure the stale air, the bad air, moist air, and all of that is actually going outside and not being stuck in your home, which is one of the reasons that we oftentimes replace your bath fan. So we're in the laundry room right now. I'm going to look at the venting for the dryer to make sure that that is the proper kind of venting and actually make sure it's vented outside properly. But this venting looks great, so we can move on. Now we're going to be testing the burners on top of the stove for carbon monoxide. And then we're going to check the oven for carbon monoxide issues. And the oven looks good. We're gonna run a blower door test here. What this does is it simulates a 20-mile-an-hour wind on all four sides of your home. It helps us figure out how much air is leaking outside of your home, so that nice warm air in the winter that you've, you know, been turning your furnace up for, we don't want that air escaping. And also during the summer, if you're air conditioning or cooling your home, we don't want that cool air to escape either. After we're done with weatherization, your numbers should go down quite a bit. Typically for Washtenaw County, we're looking at numbers between 20 and 50% air reduction. So air leaks are dropped down by that number. So I've completed my energy audit. There's lots of improvements that we can make on this home. Typically on average, our weatherization jobs, you know, average cost would be right around $10,000. That could be higher or lower than that, depending on what the needs are for the home. I've been doing this work, you know, for over 20 years now. I've done over 2,000 audits and I'm super passionate. It's a perfect blend of helping people, making energy bills lower for people, helping save the environment. We have tons of funds that we just received to be able to do this large scale throughout the county. We're very excited to get into your home and help you save energy.